in bed. Good night.
No, good morning!
Because you see, we're done wallowing around with nothing to do. Oh, thank you, Bradley. An excellent start to a wonderful day. I assure you. Hey, pay attention. This will be on the test. The test being your death. Good job. I have finally figured out what I wanted to do. And I will tell you in this episode. I will not be doing it because it's kind of a big project. And it's something that I've kind of wanted to do for a long while in Minecraft, but I've never really pulled it off. And honestly, I'm not sure how I'm going to pull it off, considering what the idea is. I don't have all the specifics down, I just had an idea in my head sort of thing. But I was over here looking at all this big expanse of land, and I was basically going around going, I can't just wander around spouting nonsense for like 3 more videos while I wait for the next update. Or rather, I can't just go wasting the next few videos purely because I want the next update. So I'm gonna have to do something, but what? Well, I'm gonna try and do something that that I have wanted to do for a long time and have pulled off very poorly in the past. I really like, in Minecraft, more modern to, like, 1950s era sort of rural setting. Rural to modern, rural to urban setting. So, building a road, a classic American road, with buildings along it that look like they belong either in a town in the 1950s or in the city. The buildings that would look like they have air conditioning or like places of business. I do have a couple buildings in mind. I want to make, like, an apartment building. And, an old lady's house. Like, a classic A-frame. And, a gas station. Maybe even a library. I'd love to make a library. I'm not all that great at making libraries. In fact, I haven't made a good building. I haven't made a really great building that I am 100% content with in many, many years. I'm getting off where I should be. I am clearing off the wrong place. It's not that important to me because I don't like tall grass in general. However, yeah. I should honestly be going up and digging some layers off, because I do need... I'm not going to make this entire thing on an incline going down there. That's a bad idea. I need to level this out some. It's not Bradley's, but this will do. Oh, Bradley. A chicken after my own heart. I guess that would be a good stretch, too. Nah. I don't want to make this project too big. That's the thing. I want this to be a fairly contained project. I want to make a single road like a miracle mile. Like some guy's driving his Chevy down the Miracle Mile to go pick up some ladies and... wearing his leather jacket. Kind of like Freeside in Fallout 3, Fallout New Vegas. With the kings. It was probably my favorite faction. Of my favorite group in that game. Mostly because all the other ones kind of suck. I don't know everything about it. I know just about as much as I do from my Fallout 3... my Wasteland Ted play... thing. Play session? I'm not sure entirely how to describe it. It's not important. What is important is this project is going to take a lot of level land. And, I am going to have to go... I should have closed my browser in between videos, and I didn't even think of it. I have my browser open, and it shouldn't be. Today, at the time of recording, is the day that Starbound finally gets its official release, and I can't wait for that to happen! Oh, it happens just after noon, but it's like 8:30 in the morning. And I could totally go for a breakfast something. Like a McDonald's something or other. It is what, the second to last Friday in August. Not August, July. I don't know why I said August. Especially since it is clearly not August. I am going to fill in this lake immediately. There may be a time at some point in which I actually reset the world and get a new world. Purely for world generation reasons. There at some point, they add the option to customize your worlds. Like, where do you want diamonds to show up? How high do you want... how often do you want ponds like this? Not lakes, but ponds. How often do you want lava lakes to appear? Lava ponds to appear. Do you want lava lakes? And I kind of do. I kind of want a lot of that. I want to like customize where I really should have a bucket of water right now. I don't. It's a little cathartic, I suppose, to go around breaking tall grass. So I. Anyone who's watched this channel probably knows that there was a server called the Anesthesia server that I went on, and it's either that or no one knows about it because I didn't post any videos, and I think I thought I did, but I didn't. So either I'm stupid or I'm not stupid, and either you know about it or you don't. But anyway, I tried to do a sort of modern setting. Or rather, a sort of rural to urban setting before on that server. And I set up a giant road system, and I was like, I'm going to make a city. And I don't know what I'm going to call it, and I'm not going to call it Anesthesia City, because that would be silly. And I'm not going to call it Shemp City, because some guy suggested it. So I never decided on a name for the city. In fact, the entire project was just designed awful. It was just awful. I was like, this is where the supermarket's gonna go. I never built that supermarket. I never built any supermarket. I'd like to build a supermarket, but if that's complicated. So, boop. I gotta go home now. It's time. Do you hear skeleton? I heard skeleton, but I do not see skeleton, nor am I being shot at by skeleton, so I guess that's good, question mark? Bradley, I'm coming home, Bradley. Did you miss me? Oh, you little chicken, you. Bradley, the chicken. He's just sticking around. That's just it. I've decided he's sticking around. His name is Bradley, and he is my pet chicken. So, I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to link these two areas. If I am, at all. This may be just like, this is the area. It's a snapshot of a rural American town. So it might just be small and separated from everything else. So, anyway, on the anesthesia server, I made this entire road system. It was something like 15 blocks across, three blocks for the sidewalk on both sides of the road, something like 9 blocks wide of smooth stone, the entire length of the road. I may even copy the road schematic for this project that I'm going to make now. I'm just talking about it while I break grass. This is basically one of the boring parts of this thing. So, 9 blocks across of smooth stone with 3 on either side. Yep, that's 15 right there. And the blocks would usually consist of about 9 plots? With the one in the center being mostly ignored because it would be in the middle of a whole bunch of buildings. So there might be an alleyway here or there that, like, lead to a basketball court or something inside of this 15 by 15 center place. And I planned for all the buildings to be, like, urban-looking stuff, like skyscrapers and everything looks cool and, like, it never happened. Nope. I got this massive road network set up with plots, with properly lit plots. And it even had a system of lines going down, like, made of glowstone. Road lines. It was all smooth stone because, honestly, asphalt doesn't look black. Come on, it looks gray. Enough people have been driving over it. It looks gray. Maybe it looks black when it's laid down, but it eventually looks gray. And there's no way in hell I'm getting that much black wool and risking it burning up, catching fire in some way, and burning to hell. There goes my entire roadbed. No, I decided to go with non-flammable materials, as I usually like to do. Eventually, I'm going to get all sorts of... Well, it's not Bradley's, but I'll take it. It's not Bradley's, but I'll take it. I'm going to say that for every darn egg I pick up, except for Bradley's. He's my favorite chicken right now, alright? He's my favorite chicken. He's my pet chicken. I'm gonna have to make, like, a gravestone for Bradley. It's either that or he's just gonna grow old and stay standing in one spot for the rest of his life. I'm pretty sure I have, like... I have a fence I could keep him in with. I don't think it would work, but considering it's just leaf blocks around him, so the fence wouldn't connect, but, you know. I could keep him right at the entrance for the rest of his dang life, but I don't feel like doing that, really. I like knowing that Bradley kind of has a choice of where to go. So anyway, back to the city idea. The problem was I was on a server full of people who were not sharing my mindset. I put down, like, building codes. After the first guy built his building in my in the city. And you know what he built? He built a redstone A-frame house. Not a A-frame house made of redstone. No. It was legit. It was a pretty good house. Pretty good actual business. It was selling redstone and redstone accessories. And it even had, like, all sorts of redstone contraptions going through it. Do I have any more soda? I do not. Lame sauce. I should really get some more, considering I do intend to, maybe I shouldn't record Starbound today. So, after that point, not only that, but some other guys decided, I'm gonna set up my own house in the, on the edge of the... in this plot over here. This guy actually took two plots and then didn't get rid of the border between them. The least you could have done is put up a fence, dang it. I wish the fences in this game looked a lot different. I wish they weren't so clearly farm fences. I want there to be, like, this fence belongs to a rural house. A rural building. And this fence looks like a chain link fence. The iron bars don't look like fences. They look like iron bars. But that's as close to a chain link fence as you'll get. I did actually make, like, three houses. Three buildings. One was a library. There was a cafe that I intended to be, like, very similar to Starbucks, but they give awful products and, like, charge exorbitant prices for garbage, basically. It was cocoa beans and a thing of milk. Or water. And it's gonna be, quote-unquote, coffee. And it's just for a gag. Satire, I suppose. It's gonna be something along the lines of, this is what Starbucks is. Really expensive stuff for not all that great quality. Except for the fact that I believe that... I personally think that Starbucks is amazing in its quality, but it's still far too expensive. I kind of want to go over there, but at the same time, I really don't. I also hate that, like, floating triangle in the dang sky. It pisses me off. But what can you do? I can go over and take that out, take it down, but I won't. It looks like a mountain that hasn't loaded. And yet I know it's just a floating mountaintop from a mountain that I guess never came into existence. So I did make an apartment building, and I kind of intend to make a similar apartment building, but it was like two or three apartments, and it wasn't all that great. But I do intend to make, like, a similar apartment building. I want to make a gas station because I really haven't made a gas station ever before. I'm gonna fill it with stuff. I'm so glad I'm actually using the Steam controller for this because my mouse, when you click really fast, my mouse squeaks. And the Steam controller does not. It's a very interesting experience using this controller. I think it intends for me to use the flat of my thumb, but I use like the tip of my thumb instead. Where is the sun? Okay, sun's almost going down. We gotta wrap this up. So I want to make an old lady's house, and she's just sort of living there. Maybe her lawn is a little unkempt. That word itself seems really weird to me. Unkempt. It seems like it should be unkept, but unkept is not a word. It's not actually a word in the English language. It should be. It makes sense. You keep your hair looking nice. So if your hair is messy, it's unkept. It's what unkempt is. But unkempt is the word instead. I have to look up the etymology of unkempt. Where it came from. Its origins. What it means. Other than, like, messy. So I set down building rules, and I threw a fit. And I really shouldn't have, because it's a server that I opened the city for people to build in, and then I threw a fit when people built things. It was really stupid, and just because it was my idea, I couldn't exactly have given the idea to anyone else. I couldn't have, like, put it into their minds before they came and built it, because they built it without me knowing that they were going to build it. And I was actually going to, like, sell plots to people. I wanted compensation for my land so that I could continue to build the massive arena that I was building there. It just started out as the arena. It was like, I'm going to make a place where you can fight. And people can come by and beat the snot out of one another. And if anything sneaks up and starts murdering me, I am heading home. Except I'm going to head home right now because I'm done digging that. Wait a second. I'm not digging. I'm done digging. The rose. I miss them being roses. Fart! Yeah, they're roses. I love them. Look at them. I miss them. I thought it was stupid when they changed them to posies. Why can you not have a rose and a rose bush? That doesn't make any sense to me. It's like, oh, thank you, Bradley. How many eggs? Oh, 10 eggs. Excellent. So, to recap, rural miracle mile plan, and I'm going to work on that for a while, and I will see you next time on that guy over there is going to die on Minecraft. See you then, folks.